Welcome to our today's do-it-yourself topic. What is living in denial? Upsetting and traumatic events that may possibly trigger denial in us. The damages caused when we are living in denial. For real valuation through this topic, please focus only on the content. Kindly ignore my lacunas in pronunciation, tone, expression, accent, grammar, my looks and even this video's background. For the content of this video, please ask. What is denial and how does living in denial help or hurt us? This is my opinion and I might be totally wrong, but I have discovered that only those people who can be positive all throughout their life, 24/7 in all 365 days are those if they are only of B positive blood group. Now let us find out what is living in denial means. I have identified 26 clarifications. First, denial is our body's inbuilt primary subconscious defense mechanism for coping with catastrophic failures, very great grief and shocking situations. This acts as a temporary shock absorber so that we get time to adjust with the reality. Denial is healthy and useful only for very short time and only in catastrophic situations of unprecedented nature. While facing a shattering event, to cope with emotional stress, painful thoughts, threats, fears, anxieties, many times our mind refuses to acknowledge and recognize that something is wrong. In this article, we are exploring what type of permanent damages living in denial can cause us in our life's major aspects if the denial continues for long. The biggest danger of living in denial is that it also numbs our positive emotions, such as making us immune to excitements, fun, happiness or enjoyment and bliss from fulfilling relationships, success, etc. But many of us has adopted it as our default strategy to fall back on subconsciously, and for some it has become part of the nature. So many of us could be living in denial without realizing it, which can be referred as ostrich syndrome or living in fool's paradise, as the proverb goes. Biggest harm takes place when we lie to ourselves, when we hide our own feelings from ourselves, when we refuse to acknowledge what is happening within us mentally, physically and emotionally, when we are not being sincere, objectively straightforward and brutally honest with ourselves about us. We are actually approaching a stage where we would need treatment and therapies of various kind if we are not already there, in case we live with denial for long. When we live in denial, it hampers our ability to bounce back, handle future challenges and lead a healthy, fulfilling life. Some people can remain for years or the rest of life in denial. Emotionally healthy people are able to bounce back from denial to understand their emotional instabilities, then taking action to start living their lives as best as they can. The impact of traumatic events on our self-being and our being in denial mode should not go beyond maximum few days to weeks, depending upon the severity of this emotionally shocking event. If it goes beyond that, we definitely need help of an expert to heal and come back to life. Sometimes, many of us use denial to hide from feeling any disturbing negative emotions, or to avoid feeling that, or to suppress that, like shame, fear, guilt or embarrassment, etc. Sometimes feeling positively may be just as threatening as negative feelings, which is part of denial. People with low self-esteem, when their emotions exposes their vulnerability in relationship, may go on aggressive attack mode, which could also be through passive aggressive tactics. Normally, denial seems easy way out and easier to continue. but it will leave your life with void, emptiness, unexplained sadness, joylessness, etc. While defense mechanisms are often thought of as negative reactions, we all need them to temporarily ease stress and protect self-esteem during critical times, allowing us to focus on what is necessary at that moment. Some of these defenses can be more helpful than others. For example, utilizing humor to overcome a stressful, anxiety-provoking situation can actually be an adaptive defense mechanism. Playing the victim most strongly correlates with cognitive dissonance. A person is aware of an uncomfortable truth, yet childishly acts as if they have no control. Denial is pushing against what is unwanted. To refuse to accept something, that is why whatever we resist persists. Denial does not work because for long term, unless you know where you actually are, you cannot visualize where you want to be. Denial is not just about denying that there is a problem. Denial in a relationship makes a relationship impossible. The one who is not coping with denial is in torment because they are not just alone, they are alone in their pain. The single most painful thing a person can experience is going through something painful entirely on their own. To help someone with their pain, it has to be acknowledged, seen, felt, and understood. Now, there are 8 upsetting and traumatic events that can possibly trigger denial in us. Losing your job suddenly, which has happened in Corona. And I know a few people who leave their houses at the same time as usual, when they used to have the job, and they maintain this facade for months without telling their family. Losing a loved one with whom the person had very deep emotional attachment. Separation and divorce from someone you're still very, very emotionally dependent and attached. Being bypassed for a prized and much anticipated promotion or a project. Sudden identification of a terminal or serious illness. Losing your financial saving, being bankrupt suddenly. Being victim of regular violence and abuse. Very upsetting relationship conflicts, oppressions, violence in relationship. The damages denial does to us, there are 6 damages. It creates relationship issues where there should not be any, may push us into depression, increase our anxiety levels, induce low self-worth, low self-esteem, low self-confidence in us, create unexplained and repeated illnesses without any reason or cause, may lead to harmful addictions, even like taking painkillers and antidepressants daily.